Hello everyone, welcome to Jargus Range Review. This time we'll be looking at the very first episode of Power Rangers Beast Morphers, Beast Unleashed. And this is the very first episode produced by Hasbro. So let's see how they handle the 26th season of the series. First of all, it starts out pretty damn well. I mean, they're really tapping into the Power Rangers lore already. Because we're starting out by they create a new form of clean energy called Morphex, which taps into the power of the Morphin Grid. You know, the same place the Rangers get all their powers, but only in this city called Coral Harbor. But the mayor disapproves of this plan, because he knows that in the past, Rita Repulsa, Sledge, and Galvanax have tried to steal the objects that use Morphin Grid powers so they could have their attempt to rule the universe. So already, they're going way to the past and present just with referencing past Ranger season. Now, we do not know what sort of facility Grid Battle Force is. That's the organization that's creating its energy. Is it privately run? Is it government run? It could be government sponsored because it is making all this energy for the whole city. And it got the mayor involved, who is supposed to be one to flip the switch to start the power. Though, his concerns get pretty much taken care of when it is revealed that they have also use the same Morphex energy to create Power Rangers, or they're about to create Power Rangers. Apparently, they're going to be activated at the same time as the rest of the city gets their power. But before that happens, we have the mayor's son, his name is Devin. He is doing a karate class at a gym, but he's listening to headphones, to which the young adult instructor gets very agitated with, and he starts to fight him to try and teach him a lesson about being challenged. The instructor's name is Blaze, and he's pretty hot-tempered. But his friend, also in the class, whose name is Rovi, does not approve of this fighting, tries to get him to stop. But it does get stopped when the mayor arrives to get his son, and he's not too happy. The mayor is really direct and commanding. He reminds me of Colonel Truman. Only, I don't know what to think of his voice, because he sounds like over-the-top serious. I'm not sure how to describe it. Thing is, it doesn't come off quite much as serious as it does cartoonish serious to me. Which is strange considering this is, he's a person in a live action series. But that's a minor nitpick. I mean, he's mad at his son because he threw off a job interview that he had set up with him. Because he don't know anything about cleaning carpets. Of course, his dad tells him that all you do is spend your time practicing karate and playing video games. That's not going to get you anywhere. And when Devin finds out his father is going to Grid Battle Force, he wants to go because they have a battle simulator there that he wants to check out. Of course, the young fella gets denied, but he sneaks off anyway. He makes a copy of his father's ID with the phone, and he sneaks in to get past security, while his father has to deal with the regular security check. And so once Mayor Daniels does get into the facility, he's greeted by a laundry girl named Zoe, who tried to be a cadet because she wanted to make big changes in the world instead of little ones. And the mayor says that just keep to your beliefs and one day you will be able to make those changes. So he's not really a bad guy, he's just pretty strict with his son. Which is understandable considering he's shown to be a bit of a slacker. In a way, he almost reminds me of Jack from SPD. Now, Devin, disguised as one of the employees, ends up inside the morphing lab, where he hides out in the corner. And inside a big tube of Morphex, which is basically the energy from the Morphin Grid turned into a liquid substance, he sees some sort of cobra head pop out in front of him. It freaks him out, he knocks over some boxes, and he gets caught and thrown into a holding cell. But he tries to explain to everyone that there's a virus there. It's inside the Morphex. To which they don't believe him because they think they would have seen a penetration of a system before then. Now, leading this operation is Commander Shaw, who I assume is in control of all of Morph Battle Force, or Grid Battle Force. I keep forgetting what it's called. Don't worry, I'll get it consistent pretty soon. And Nate Silva, who is a prodigy and genius, who was able to tap into the Morphin Grid at age 10, and he was a key developer of the Morphex technology. And we have three people who are ready to be transformed. The first is Blaze, the other is Rovi, who did have a girlfriend named Roxy, but he decided he had to break out with her because there was a strict rule that the Rangers can't be dating each other. So apparently his duty that he would have from being a Ranger was more important to him than his relationship. So that hurt her, and obviously he wasn't happy about it, but to him, it was just a rule and he had to follow it. Sounds like a couple of other Blue Rangers we've had in the past. I can't recall their names at the moment. So finally, the mayor flips the switch to activate the Morphex power for the entire city. And in doing so, we'll activate the Rangers' powers as well, give them all the energy they need. Unfortunately, the virus pops up and starts trying to corrupt the Rangers. What it really does is creates avatars from their bodies. Basically, evil clone counterparts. So the entire inside of Grid Battle Force is really messed up, to the point where Devin is able to just open the door to his holding cell and run out and see what's going on. Of course, he runs to the lab, and Zoe, who wants to make a difference, decides to run off to see what's going on. Together, they see part of what's happening, and with some help with Nate, they use a blaster to disable the energy, so only two of our three potential Rangers are being affected. Rovi is still himself, but the other two have been knocked unconscious. So these evil twins go off and fighting. No more sequence yet at all. It's just them battling out inside the lab, using a lot of equipment as defensive weapons. Until Nate gets the plan of using the teleporters to just warp them far, far away, which we later find out is another dimension, as one of the last lines of the episode. And that was a really nice fight scene. It went by pretty quickly, but it didn't seem rushed at all, which is great. So far, I have no real complaints. But to top it off, before they get teleported, Nate sends an activation that makes Devin, Zoe, and Rovi to be the new three Rangers. But he says that those avatars are pretty intelligent, and they will be back. Oh, and they are under the command of Evox, a threatening computer virus that wants to take over the Morphin Grid. Just like Mayor Daniels warned of. Of course, so far, no one outside of Battle Force seems to know about this incident. So yeah, Devin's a Red Ranger and Zoe's a Blue Ranger. Yellow Ranger. But they also had their DNA fused partially with animals. So Zoe can move like a jackrabbit, Devin like a cheetah, and Ravi has the strength of a gorilla. And Commander Shaw welcomes them aboard, and she states that they're going to have to do some training in the battle simulator. To which Devin, of course, is entirely excited about. And that he wasn't expecting to have all this when he got up in the morning. Of course, not all is well and good. Blaze and Roxy are semi-comatose. The bodies are fine, but their minds are not inactive because they're linked to the avatar clones of them. And only by defeating those can they be returned to normal. So instead, they're pretty much just kept alive in machine. And Ravi especially is upset about this because he feels he's partially responsible to what happened to Roxy. So we can definitely see him being extremely serious. I predict Devin's going to have a lot of arguments with Ravi over how strict to be, as well as the rules at Grid Battle Force. Now Zoe, it's hard to say. She's optimistic and wants to make a difference. And I gotta say, they adapted pretty well. It was Ravi that actually started leading the battle as soon as he got transformed. Partially, I guess, because he was ready for it. So yeah, I see a big rivalry between our Red and Blue Rangers over who's going to lead the charge. Zoe seems like a middle ground. She's idealistic, but she's putting also the effort to go through the formal channels to be where she is. So she might be the mediator between these two personalities, if they come into conflict at all. Which I'm sure they will. So it would be sort of be like Jack and I think Sky was SPD Blue Ranger. That's what I see this potentially being like. Though considering there's a lot more personal stakes involved, this could be a lot more interesting than it was handled there. So overall, this is a great episode. I give it a 10 out of 10. I had nothing to complain about. We only had a little bit of action, but it was really well done and a ton of world building. And we have a lot of stuff to look forward to. We get to see the Rangers' arsenal, which can be teleported anywhere they want. We're tapping into the deepest lore of the series, which is the Morphin Grid and referencing all different past villains. So all in all, this is a lot of stuff to look forward to. The one thing that threw me off is that we didn't see the intro sequence, which is only 30 seconds long this time, until like 7 minutes into the show. Basically a third of the way of the episode. I don't know if that's going to be a regular thing or just how they handled it the first time, but it did take me back. So I'm going to be interested to see just what happens. How do they introduce the Zords? Just where did Evox come from? All sorts of things. So I'd definitely be on the look for the next episode. But until then, this has been Jargus. Thanks for watching, and let the power protect you.